My diagnosis came completely unexpected. I lost consciousness while running, and I broke several teeth in the fall. As I was in the hospital checking for the causes of the fall, they diagnosed me with Brugada syndrome.
The average age of death is 40 years old, which is what I am now. So what they did at the hospital was implant an ICD, which is a cardioverter defibrillator. It's not a difficult surgery because it's minimally invasive,
but which means a lifetime commitment to regular checkups and changes of the device. For 15 years now, I've been on the other side of the screen in radiology, and it was very difficult for me to accept my new role as a patient.
I learned about Professor Papone because after the diagnosis, I started Googling about the Brugada syndrome and also was looking at the experts in the field, so his name obviously came up, and he's a key opinion leader in electrophysiology.
The Brugada is a genetic disease. And in the general opinion, the sentence of having a Brugada is the worst sentence possible. It's not a cancer.
Yeah.
It's a solvable problem. 10 years ago, we started a program to better understand the cause, the mechanism, and the substrate of Brugada. We discovered that Brugada is localized on the anterior wall of right ventricle. And we developed a strategy to eliminate the abnormal cells. Actually, this type of procedure is performed in very few centers in the world. In the last 10 years, we have enough results regarding the very good outcome after the ablation of this condition. We are very happy and very satisfied of this procedure. So I understand you are afraid of this story. I offer the patient the opportunity to give a look. I can show you the procedure.
Yeah, that would be nice.
I decided to work in this field because one of the most difficult topics during my university experience was just the electrophysiology. When the patient has a palpitation, or the patient has a collapse, or has a sudden death, something is not working well in the electricity of the heart. We discovered many years ago the possibility to map and to identify the fibers responsible for these disturbances. At that time, it was a taboo to entry into the heart, navigate into the heart, and to map the electricity of the heart. That procedure was considered an unethical procedure because potentially dangerous, very complicated, and not possible for every physician. Every day I'm very much preoccupied of what I'm going to do. Small mistake can have a huge consequence. So I need to be very concentrated in every single procedure. With the arrival of new technologies, especially the imaging technology, we will have the opportunity to discover many other things without invasive approaches. So I see my future to assess the population, to predict the arrhythmias and not just eliminate the arrhythmias, and to think how to improve the life and to prolong the life.
I like that with the job I have, we can improve what's out there for people like me now, because I really felt this on my skin. If this happened 20 years ago, it would have been completely different.
The diagnosis made me realize how fragile our normality is. On the other hand, it made me aware also of how much more power we have on our own time, actions, energy, and passions. And how much what we do every day matters, exactly because of this fragility.